It's opening morning here, Stevenson County, turkey hunting with Andy Wales and Travis. We're about to get in the blind here, but we got a group of four toms we saw last night in the field behind me here that are really lighting it up this morning. It's getting close to fly down time, so it's been fun listening to them so far. Hopefully they'll make their way over here soon.
So this was our setup. We knew the birds were roosted in the woods from the night before. So Andy and I got in a blind northeast of them, and Travis was to the west of them, and he ended up having all the action.
Thank you. this morning. Had see the woods there roosting. Counted 17 of them came out. He was part of three different gobblers, group of three, who saw the decoy and came in to check what's out. Shot pretty quick because we only get away, but it would be a pretty fun hunt.
Now that Travis had his tag filled, Andy and I hunted the rest of that day. We had a couple of close calls, but nothing happened. Day two started real slow. It was overcast, even a little bit of snow coming down. But by mid-morning, our luck changed.
It's 9:15. We got out of the blind and headed to a new area. Travis spotted a turkey off the road, not too far from here, so Andy and I parked the truck, and right now I'm sitting by the little hog barn. He's down the fence row about 70 yards. Ooh, there he is. I think I see a turkey.
I watched this Tom make it across the field to this other fence line. He would not come to the calls. Eventually we gave up on him and went looking for another one.
Well, it's about 12 o'clock. We can hunt till 1, so we're getting down to the wire here. We're gonna take off, head for home, so we're gonna try a little turkey drive. Travis is going to circle around, park the truck up there, and kind of walk through this roost woods where they've been hanging out throughout the day. There's nothing gobbling going on. A little bit of strutting action, but just no talking at all. It's weird. Now we got some snow coming again, so it's kind of a last-ditch effort. A little bump and dump. Give it a try.
Well, that didn't work. There goes two long beards the other way.
All right, time to move again. Travis said he saw a bird up in front of me here, down this tree line. It's 12:40, gives me 20 minutes. He said it was a strutter and some hens.
right. About 25 minutes ago, Travis saw this bird in the corner of this field. And I think I hiked probably a half a mile to get here. And I get to the corner, and I didn't know where they're at because they're not in the field, but they were right tucked into this fence row. And one of them, there actually was two toms and a hen, but one hen, or the tom ran the other direction, so I'm like, oh man. This guy ran down the fence line, and I never saw him come out. The hen flew, so I'm like, I think he's still in the fence row. So I started slipping up as quiet as I could. I got to within probably 20 yards, and he took off. And this time I didn't miss. Yes. Oh, I'm pooped. But it feels so good. Quitting time is 1 o'clock. I think I shot this guy at 12:55. By the time I took my first picture, it was 1 o'clock. So. Talk about down to the wire.